Hey everyone, and welcome to Qcoin vs Gate.io. In this video, I'll compare the Qcoin exchange with the Gate.io exchange, and I'll compare their security, their fees and costs, their crypto offering, the platform quality, and their overall comparison. Now, when we're talking about the security, both crypto exchanges are equivalent. On Qcoin, you have the login password. On Qcoin, you can enable the two-factor authentication using the Google Authenticator. This means that once you have entered your password, you will also have to fill in a 6-digit code generated in the Google Authenticator app. Gate.io does also offer this option. The only difference is that on Qcoin it is called the Google Verification and on Gate.io it's called two-factor authentication. But as you can see, because of the icon, it's the same authenticator app, in this case the Google Authenticator. On Qcoin you can also set up an email verification, used for the verification in withdrawals, API creations, etc. On Gate.io, this is the same. It is used as a safety verification when you receive, notice, login, withdraw or change safety settings. Also, on both of the exchanges, you have the possibility or option to set up the SMS verification. On Qcoin, I haven't set this up personally, but as you can see, it's available on Qcoin as well as on Gate.io. On Qcoin, you've got something called a trading password. The trading password is a password you have to fill in before being able to place, buy or sell orders. You will also have to fill in this code when you want to withdraw or create an API. On Gate.io you have a similar thing, it's called the fund password. And once you fill in your fund password on Gate.io, you will be able to do whatever you want for 1 hour without having to fill in your fund password again. Now, both of the exchanges also offer something called an anti-phishing code. As you can see, an anti-phishing code can protect you from phishing attempts or frauds. When set, this code will be included in emails from Gate.io. Any other email without this code are a scam. On Gate.io, you have something called the email safety phrase, the login safety phrase, and the withdrawal safety phrase. It's basically the same thing, except on Qcoin, you have it for your email, your login, and your withdrawal, and on Gate.io, it's the same thing for all actions. So that's why, for me, Qcoin and Gate.io are equivalent when we're talking about security. I will now go ahead and talk about their fees and costs. Comparing the Gate.io fees to the Qcoin fees, you will see that on Qcoin you have to pay a 0.10% maker fee as well as a 0.10% taker fee. This is when your trading value in Bitcoin is below 1000 Bitcoin in the past 30 days. Now, on Gate.io, no matter how much you trade, your maker fee as well as your taker fee will be 0.06%. So it's clear that on Gate.io you will have to pay less fees if you're trading cryptocurrencies. The 0.06% fee is on Gate.io spot market. On their future markets, you will have to pay a maker fee of 0.00% and a taker fee of 0.04%. According to the Qcoin website, there's no difference in either a taker or maker fee for trading on their spot market or on their future markets. With that being said, I will now go ahead and talk about the deposit and withdrawal fee. On Gate.io, your deposit fee is 0 and your withdrawal fee will be 0% plus 0.001 Bitcoin, and your daily withdrawal limit is 100 Bitcoin. On Qcoin, the Bitcoin fee is 0.0005 for withdrawing, and your minimum withdrawal is 0.002 Bitcoin. Now, the Gate.io fee on Qcoin for withdrawing is 0.01. On Gate.io, the withdrawal fee for Ethereum is 0.011. So that's a little bit more Ethereum you will have to pay in fees if you want to withdraw, because again, the depositing fee on both of the exchanges is completely free. Now, the withdrawal fee on Gate.io for Cardano, another big cryptocurrency, is 17.78 Cardano, which, in comparison to Gate.io, where Cardano, the fee you'll have to pay, is only 1, that's quite a big difference. So that's why I think that Gate.io is a better crypto exchange if we're talking fees and costs wise. On Gate.io's spot market, there's a total of 96 USDT pairs available for trading, and on Qcoin, the spot pairs available for trading in USDT are 86. This leads me to believe that Gate.io has a wider crypto offering. Qcoin, however, has more perpetual pairs available for trading, with Gate.io sitting at 30 pairs available for trading, and Qcoin having over 70 pairs available for perpetual trading. So because the spot pairs available on both crypto exchanges are around the same level, and the perpetual amount of pairs available for trading on Qcoin are way higher, I think that for crypto offering, you should use Qcoin. I'll now go ahead and talk about the platform quality. I think both exchanges look pretty good. However, I think that Gay.io has a few points to improve on. When you're logging in, the message you will get is incorrect, and sometimes even the trading page doesn't work the way it's supposed to. The change of a cryptocurrency pair in percentage sometimes doesn't load or is being displayed in the wrong color, which of course isn't the way it should be. Now also I think that Gay.io just in general has quite a bit to improve on the way their site looks. For people who are new to crypto, I think that Gay.io is quite overwhelming, and KuCoin has done quite a good job at making sure their website is easy to navigate. Now still, if you're new to KuCoin or to crypto in general, I think that you will still have to learn how to navigate their platform. In conclusion, I believe that both of the crypto exchanges are able or will be able to improve their website to make it more beginner friendly. And that's why I think that you have to decide for yourself what you think about the platform quality for both of the crypto exchanges, because I believe that it comes down to personal preference. With that being said, I will now go ahead and give the overall comparison. Both of the crypto exchanges have security that's quite the same. However, Gay.io is cheaper in fees and costs, the crypto offering is bigger on KuCoin, and the platform quality, like I said, comes down to personal preference. If you still need to register your account, make sure to use my link in the description for KuCoin as well as Gay.io to get 20% of all trading fees and commissions. If you found this video helpful, let me know by leaving a like or subscribing to my channel for more tutorials about cryptocurrencies.